Assalamu alaikum, dear students, dear grade 9 students. This is your biology teacher, Ms. Hina Zahid. Waiting for a few more students to join me up. Alishba, Vanya, and rest of the students, I welcome you in another biology class. This is to compensate the loss during the thunderstorms occurring in Karachi previous days. Please open up your book at page number 44. Now we are going to study about the formation of organs and organ systems. Organs and organ systems. So keep your books opened with you. Another thing which I wanted to inform you that the self-study questions are assigned from your teacher to all of you. Those self-study questions are given to you in your benefit. PDF files जो आपको notes receive हो गए हैं, वो notes तो आपकी learning के लिए और आपकी preparation के लिए हैं. Those notes will help you out. लेकिन जो मेहनत हम खुद करते हैं, वो मेहनत हमारे लिए बहुत ज़्यादा valuable होती है. आपको जो questions teacher assign करती हैं, वो questions आपको एक दिन, दो दिन में नहीं करने. आई नो कि बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, लेकिन जब उन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स फाइंड करने के लिए आप अपनी बुक्स को ओपन करेंगे और आप उसमें से थरल रीडिंग करेंगे चैप्टर की, तो उससे आपकी थ्री डायमेंशनल प्रिपरेशंस हो जाएंगी. नंबर वन, जब आप उन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स फाइंड करेंगे तो उससे आपको एक तो एमसीक्यूज की प्रिपरेशन ऑटोमेटिकली हो जाएगी, और इस तरीके से पूरी बुक से कहीं से भी कोई एमसीक्यू अपीयर हो जाए आपके पेपर में तो आपके लिए बहुत आसानी होगी उसका आंसर करने के लिए. आपको सोचना नहीं पड़ेगा, एमसीक्यूज याद नहीं करने पड़ेंगे. इसके अलावा जब आप थरली बुक रीड करेंगे और आंसर्स को फाइंड करने के काबिल होंगे तो आपको अपने नोट्स प्रिपेयर करने में आसानी होगी और वो नोट्स आपको याद नहीं करने पड़ेंगे. ठीक है, सो ह्यूमन ब्रेन बहुत अच्छे से काम करता है अगर हम उसको बहुत बेस्ट यूटिलाइजेशन दें. यानी हम अगर अपने ब्रेन को बहुत परफेक्टली यूटिलाइज करें तो हम अपने ब्रेन से बहुत ज़्यादा बेनिफिट ऑब्टेन कर सकते हैं. अब देखिए, अगर 10 चैप्टर्स आपके सिलेबस में इंक्लूडेड है तो उन 10 चैप्टर्स के लिए आपको कितने ज़्यादा एमसीक्यूज और कितने ज़्यादा क्वेश्चंस याद करने पड़ेंगे. और जब आप उनको, अगर जो क्वेश्चंस आपको असाइन किए जा रहे हैं वो क्वेश्चंस अगर आप खुद से उनको डिज़ाइन करने लग जाएंगे आंसर्स और बुक को ओपन करके बुक को थरली रीड करेंगे तो आपके लिए कितना आसान हो जाएगा कि बहुत सारी चीज़ें आपको याद नहीं करनी पड़ेंगी, वो आपकी प्रैक्टिस से ऑटोमेटिकली आपको याद हो जाएंगी और आपको नोट्स डिज़ाइन करने आ जाएंगे. इस तरीके से जब आप क्लास टेंथ में जाएंगे तो आपके लिए और ज़्यादा आसानी होगी कि आप नोट्स डिज़ाइन कर सकेंगे, अपने खुद से लिख सकेंगे. अगर कोई ऐसा क्वेश्चन पेपर में अपीयर हो जाता है जिसका आंसर आपने याद नहीं किया तो इस प्रैक्टिस की वजह से आप उस क्वेश्चन को आंसर कर सकेंगे. गेटिंग माई पॉइंट? और इसके साथ साथ जब हम इंटरमीडिएट लेवल पे जाएंगे, यानी हम फर्स्ट ईयर, सेकेंड ईयर के स्टैंडर्ड पे जाएंगे, आगे यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल पे होंगे, तो हमारे लिए बहुत आसान होगा क्योंकि वहाँ पे तो हमारे पास कोई प्रॉपर सिलेबस भी नहीं होता. बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस ऐसे होते हैं जो कि हमने याद नहीं किए होते, हमने वो अनसीन क्वेश्चंस होते हैं. तो उस तरीके से जो अभी से मैं आपको प्रिपरेशंस करवा रही हूँ ये आपकी फ्यूचर प्रिपरेशंस के लिए भी बहुत अहम है. और हमारे लिए सिर्फ मार्क्स गेन करना इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं होता, हमारे लिए इल्म हासिल करना इम्पोर्टेंट होता है. एंड डू यू नो, इल्म को हासिल किया जाता है, और जब भी हम किसी चीज़ को हासिल करते हैं तो उसके लिए हमें मेहनत करनी पड़ती है. विदाउट हार्ड वर्क सक्सेस कैन नॉट बी आवर्स. सो ऑल माय बायोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स हैव टू वर्क हार्ड. Do promise with me that you are going to start working hard and you are learning. You are not just preparing yourselves for your examination, you are learning effectively. Okay, you should be the image of your teacher. The teacher works very hard for you people, and you are all my students, my image. Okay? So thank you so very much. I'm just going to begin up with our next lesson. In the name of Allah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Shuru Allah ke paak naam se jo bada meherban nihayat rahim wala hai. We are dealing with chapter 2, which is titled as Structural Organization of Life. Structural Organization of Life. So here we are going to study about our lesson 8. What is our lesson 8 about? Lesson 8 is all about the formation of organs and organ systems. Here I just want to tell you that how do we study the structure and the structural organization of life. See, we have studied about the cell. Okay, the cell makes up tissues. We have already studied about tissues. Page number is 44. When many cells, when different similar cells combine together, they form tissues. The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life. We have already studied that cell is life, and cell is the basis of life. Now cell will be making up the structure, the whole structure of the organism, and all the living organisms are made up of cells. Animal cells are different from plant cells, bacterial cells are different from fungal cells, okay? And animal, plant cells, bacterial cells, fungal cells, all cells are different, but the basic structures of the cell, the basic definition of the cell is the same, that the cell is the basic structure and functional unit, structural and functional unit of life. So cells, when similar cells join up, they form tissues. And when similar tissues join up, what do they make? When similar tissues join up to perform a specific function, they form organs. Do you know what organs are? Correct, Alishba, correct. What are organs? Organs are the structures which are made up of similar tissues. Organs are the structures which are made up of similar kind of tissues. Or different types of tissues bhi milkar ek organ bana sakte hain, like our human arm. Our arm is an organ. Stomach. Stomach is an organ. Okay? Stomach. Hamara stomach ek organ hai. Hamara arm ek organ hai. Another thing is heart. Heart is our organ. Lungs, bladder, kidneys. Correct, Dania. Our intestine. All these are the organs. Okay? So organs are making up organ systems. Organs are making up organ systems. What does it mean? It means that cells are making up tissues. Tissues are making up organs. Organs are making up organ systems. Organ systems ki example agar hum le le organ systems mein, to organ systems ki hum kaun kaun si systems ko study kar sakte hain? We have digestive system. Correct? We have respiratory system. Correct? We have excretory system. Okay? And we have nervous system. Very, very good, Sidra. Nervous system. Okay? Another system is our muscular system. The muscles in our body. We have muscular system ke alawa, we have skeletal system. Do you know what skeletal system is? Skeletal system. Skeletal system consists of our skeleton. Exactly right, Misha. Reproductive systems. And is there any system missing? A very important system is cardiovascular system. Cardiovascular system. So do you know all these systems are working in our body, which are, yes, all the bones in our body make up our skeletal system. So do you know all these systems are working within our body to manage the things? They have to perform specific tasks. Another very important system is endocrine system. Endocrine system works with our nervous system to control all the functions of the body. And we have our immune system. Immune system protects us from diseases. It protects us from dangers. So these systems are actually specified in their function. Digestive system. What is the role of digestive system? The digestive system digests our food. Correct? Respiratory system. Yes, Misha, correct. Dania, your answer is exactly true. Respiratory system. What is the function of respiratory system? To breathe, to obtain energy from the food. Excretory system. Excretory system removes all the unwanted substances from our body. Nervous system. Nervous system controls the mechanisms which are going on within our body. Nervous system is the master system of our body. It controls each and everything which is going on within our body. It controls all the organs, all the cells of the body, all the functions which are going on, which are carried out within our body. Muscular system helps us to move and to locomote. Skeletal system helps us to locomote from one place to another, to move, and skeletal system provides us the framework of the body. It supports us. Reproductive systems are helping us to reproduce, to produce the young ones of our own kind. Cardiovascular system is the system which keeps the blood in circulation, and the blood is transporting various materials from one place to another. Endocrine system helps the nervous system to control the body functions. Immune system helps us to protect from the diseases. Immune system is the defense system of our body. Okay? Circulatory system is the other name of cardiovascular system. Cardio, heart. Vascular, vessels, cardiovascular system. And when we talk about circulatory system, it includes blood, blood vessels, and heart. So all these systems, now tell me, the teacher is asking a question that if all these systems are working together in a machinery, what do we call that machinery? What is that machinery called? All the systems, when joined up within a single body, that is called organism. All organ systems are making up an organism. Okay? Getting the point? So cells are making tissues. Tissues are making organs. Organs are making organ systems. And organ systems will be making organisms. I'm writing it in block letters. Organisms. Getting the point. What are organisms? Organisms are the bodies in which many organ systems are working together, working with each other. Okay, so this is how our life, how the organisms are organized structurally. That is the title of our chapter, The Structural Organization of Life. Now, organisms are of two types. There are generally, we are speaking generally, organisms are categorized into two broad categories. The first type of organisms are unicellular organisms. What are unicellular organisms? Organisms are always living. Dania, organisms cannot be non-living. Non-living organisms नहीं हो सकते, non-living objects हो सकती हैं, non-living things हो सकती हैं, but organisms are organisms. Organisms is the term which is actually it is actually used to address the living bodies. Okay, so organisms can be of two types, unicellular organisms. And Abdullah, your answer is correct. Sidra, your answer is correct. Javeria, correct. Unicellular organisms are the organisms which consist of only a single cell. Unicellular organisms are single-celled organisms. They consist of only a single cell. And what are multicellular organisms? Multicellular organisms are the organisms which consist of many cells. Exactly. Multicellular organisms. Okay, so these are two types of organisms which we study at our early stages in biology. Abhi aap bilkul just beginning of biology pe hain, to aapko sirf in do tarah ke organisms ke bare mein familiar karwaya ja raha hai. Iske alawa hum baad mein bahut zyada detail mein chapter 3 mein thoda sa introduction denge ke different types of organisms hain. Kuch aise organisms hain jinko hum unicellular bhi nahi keh sakte, theek hai? To unke bare mein, aise microorganisms ke bare mein bhi aapko introduce karwaya jayega during the chapter 3 lessons. Now we have to move on. Let's find out what are unicellular organisms. I just want you to see the pictures very, all the pictures which are very important to be seen. Okay, lesson 8 begins with unicellular organisms. Can you see the picture? This picture shows how many organisms can you see here? Organisms. How many organisms?
Three.
Three, correct? There are three organisms. Can you name these organisms? Amoeba, Paramecium and Euglena. Amoeba, Paramecium and Euglena. All these are three organisms which are unicellular. But you can observe, what do you observe among all these three organisms? That all three are consisting of single cell. This is amoeba. Okay, and you can see that amoeba has an irregular shaped body. Do you observe amoeba has an irregular shaped body? This is paramecium. Do you see paramecium? This paramecium has a regular shaped body. The cell of paramecium is slipper shaped. Do you observe? And the third cell is euglena. Euglena has also a regular shape. Okay, so these are three organisms which are shown here, and these are very common organisms when we talk about unicellular organisms. Now let's find out the structures which are found in these unicellular organisms and what are the difference among these three cells. Amoeba. Amoeba has a nucleus. Do you see nucleus in the paramecium also? In paramecium, we see there are two nuclei. One is macronucleus and other is micronucleus. But in amoeba, there is only a single nucleus, which is almost present in the center of the cell. Can you see the nucleus in the euglena? Yes. So nucleus is present in all unicellular organisms. Nucleus can be seen in amoeba. Nucleus can be seen in paramecium. Nucleus can be seen in euglena. So this nucleus is actually an important structure of the cell, which controls all the activities of a cell, and all unicellular organisms contain nucleus. After the nucleus, do you see the cell fluid? This cell fluid is filled with many different structures. Let's talk about amoeba. Amoeba has a contractile vacuole. Amoeba has food vacuole, and amoeba has other many substances in its cell cytoplasm. This is called cytoplasm. And all this, the whole fluid is actually containing many different types of structures. You can see paramecium. Paramecium has also is also containing cytoplasm, and you can see different structures. You can see the contractile vacuole in paramecium as well. You can see food vacuole in paramecium also. And the third is euglena. In euglena, we can see there are vacuoles. In euglena, you are observing some structures which are not present in paramecium and amoeba. Euglena contains chloroplasts. What are chloroplasts? Chloroplasts contain green pigment, which is called chlorophyll. Yes, Dania, thank you. Aapne meri mushkil aasan kar di. This is chlorophyll. So chloroplast contains a substance. This is a green pigment which is called chlorophyll, and this chlorophyll is necessary for the photosynthesis, and you can see that euglena is green in color. Euglena is green in color. That's why we see that euglena is different from amoeba and paramecium, because it contains chlorophyll. But amoeba and paramecium do not contain chlorophyll. So euglena is considered as plant-like unicellular organism. And when it loses its chlorophyll, when these chloroplasts are lost, euglena survives like an animal. Jab euglena apna chloroplast lose kar deta hai, to wo ek animal ki tarah se survive karna start kar deta hai. Amoeba, paramecium, and euglena. So these were the three different types of unicellular organisms. I wanted to explain the basic unicellular structure. Now let's talk about the organs of locomotion. Can you see? Pseudopodium. These pseudopodia are the locomotory organelles of amoeba. Can you see? These are the protoplasmic extensions in amoeba. The paramecium contains cilia. These are the hair-like structures which are found all around the body of the paramecium. And these cilia are the hair-like structures. They move back and forth, and they help the organism to locomote. And the third organism, which is euglena. Euglena contains flagellum. This flagellum is a long hair-like extension of cytoplasm and this is the locomotory organelle of euglena. So it means different unicellular organisms have different locomotory organelles. They have different types of shapes. They have different types of nuclei, and they have different pigments in them. But all of them live in the water. They cannot live outside the water because they are mainly consisting of water. Okay? So all unicellular organisms have different features, but the main basic structure, but the main basic features are the same. Let's move on to the next slide. I'm still at page number 44, and we are talking about unicellular organisms. In your book, at page 44, can you see the picture which is of? Can you tell me the name of the picture which is given here? What is this? This is amoeba. Correct, Aleshba. You are exactly correct. Amoeba, Javeria, true. Amoeba is the example we are going to study during our lesson 8, and this is the example of unicellular organism, amoeba. So what is written in your book? I'm just reading from your book first, and I'm just going to explain it, your example, this example which is given in your book, amoeba. So amoeba is a unicellular organism. It is aquatic organism. Aquatic means it is living under the water, and it is found in stagnant water. What is the meaning of stagnant? Stagnant means the water which is not flowing. The water which is not flowing is called stagnant water. So amoeba is a unicellular aquatic organism which is found in stagnant water. Jo khada hua pani hota hai, uske andar amoeba maujood hoga. It is also found in pools and ponds. It is microscopic. Microscopic means we can see amoeba. We can see amoeba with the help of a microscope only. We can see amoeba with the help of microscope only. Okay? So that's why it is called microscopic. It does not possess a definite form. Amoeba has an irregular shaped body. Amoeba changes the shape of its body. It has no fixed shape. So amoeba changes its form or shape. The structure of amoeba is very simple. And let's find out what is the main structures. What are the main structures which are found in amoeba? Amoeba is unicellular. It consists of a single cell. And the main structure, yes, we cannot see amoeba with the help of our eye. We cannot see amoeba with our naked eye. Amoeba can be seen with the help of microscope only. Sumaiya, have I answered your question? We cannot see amoeba through our naked eye, correct. Lifetime is obviously short, and they cannot survive very long without water or in a limited quantity of water. They are able to survive under the water only. So let's just discover, let's explore the structure of amoeba. Amoeba contains a nucleus. Amoeba contains a nucleus. This is the nucleus. Nucleus is found almost in the center of the cell. There are some food vacuoles jisme amoeba ne apna food kuch rakha hua hai, isko digest karega amoeba. You can see the contractile vacuole. Contractile vacuole mein amoeba ka waste product hota hai. Jab ye digestion ho jayegi food ki, to ye jo food vacuole hai, ye kya karega? Jo waste material hai, usko expel out kar dega. Aur ye contractile vacuoles mein water filled hota hai. थोड़ा सा इनके अंदर कुछ वेस्ट सब्सटेंसेस होते हैं जो ये अपनी बॉडी से एक्सपेल आउट कर देते हैं. देर आर सम क्रिस्टल्स फाउंड इन अमीबा. दीज क्रिस्टल्स आर नॉट वेरी क्लियर कि इनका क्या रोल होता है, लेकिन ये कुछ स्ट्रक्चर्स होते हैं जो अमीबा की बॉडी के अंदर मौजूद होते हैं. वी कैन सी द साइटोप्लाज्म ऑफ अमीबा इज एक्चुअली डिफ्रेंशिएटेड इनटू आउटर एक्टोप्लाज्म एंड इनर एंडोप्लाज्म. द इनर साइटोप्लाज्म इज कलरलेस ओके एंड आउटर इज द आउटर साइटोप्लाज्म इज कॉल्ड एक्टोप्लाज्म. It is transparent. Ectoplasm is transparent, colorless. And the endoplasm is actually containing many different parts of different structures and different granules. So ectoplasm is transparent. It is colorless. Okay? And endoplasm is granular. Okay, there are pseudopodia. You can see this is an extension of cytoplasm, extension of protoplasm. All these are called pseudopodia. These are the locomotory organelles of the amoeba. Okay, so here we can study about the structure of amoeba. That these different structures have different functions. Next slide shows the picture. This is the picture of amoeba. This picture is taken when the amoeba is present inside the water. You can see amoeba under the microscope, and amoeba appears like this. When you observe amoeba under a microscope, the amoeba appears like this. Now the structure, the basic structure of amoeba. There are some basic structures. Amoeba contains many pseudopodia, which are the extensions of protoplasm. Amoeba contains a nucleus. Amoeba contains some food vacuoles and contractile vacuoles also. Okay, and here we have studied amoeba. This is another picture which shows amoeba. These are the pseudopodia. अब यहाँ देखिए, यहाँ pseudopodia ज्यादा हैं. तो आप बता सकते हैं कि अमीबा किस डायरेक्शन में मूव कर रहा है. व्हाट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ अमीबा हियर? अमीबा इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स राइट. यस, इन दिस डायरेक्शन. जहां पे सुडोपोडिया ज्यादा होंगे वहां पे अमीबा मूव कर रहा होगा, और यहाँ सुडोपोडिया कम है, सो इट मीन्स अमीबा इज लीविंग दिस प्लेस. No, amoeba has no significance in human life, but amoebic dysentery. ये amoeba कुछ खास Entamoeba, Histolytica और कुछ amoeba की species ऐसी होती हैं जो हमारे अंदर जाके हमें dysentery cause कर सकती हैं, diarrhea हो जाता है उसकी वजह से हमें, और बहुत ज़्यादा loose stools pass होने लगते हैं. तो कुछ amoeba की species हमें ill कर सकती हैं. They can cause disease. Now the next example is the example of multicellular organisms. Do you see the picture here? Yes, it is mandatory to study amoeba. This picture here, it is showing the picture of Brassica campestris. And this picture is about, what is this? This is multicellular organism. This is multicellular organism. So among multicellular organisms, we will study about two animals, about two organisms. One is animal, that is frog, and second is plant, which is mustard plant. This is called mustard plant. And mustard plant is also called Brassica campestris. So mustard plant and frog. We will study these two multicellular organisms to understand the multicellular plants as well as animals. So you can see that multicellular organisms are actually made up of many cells, and here I'm showing the picture of Brassica. This Brassica is actually Brassica campestris. Brassica is the botanical name of mustard plant. The common name is mustard and the scientific name is Brassica campestris. Now moving on to the next slide here. These are the leaves of mustard plant. So we should start reading about Brassica plant, what is given in your book. See page number 45. At page number 45, it is written topic 2.8.1. The topic is 2.8.1. Brassica campestris is the botanical name of mustard and it is called sarson. You are very familiar with this plant since its oil is used for cooking and the leaves are used as vegetable saag. Aapne aksar suna hoga saag banta hai. तो जो साग बनता है वो इसके मस्टर्ड के लीव्स से बनता है. दीज आर द लीव्स विच आर शोन ऑन द स्क्रीन. द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्रासिका, वी हैव टू स्टडी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्रासिका. द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ब्रासिका कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ टू मेन पार्ट्स. द फर्स्ट इज वेजिटेटिव पार्ट्स एंड द सेकेंड इज रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स. वेजिटेटिव पार्ट्स आर द पार्ट्स विच आर नॉट responsible for reproduction. Vegetative parts are not responsible for reproduction. Like vegetative parts mein kaun kaun se parts aa jayenge? Vegetative parts mein hamare paas parts iske hain. The first is vegetative parts are, I'm not receiving your answers. Vegetative parts are roots, stem and leaves. All these are, yes Alishpa, now I have got the answer. Root, stem, leaves are the vegetative parts. These vegetative parts are not included in, not involved in reproduction. Okay, so the vegetative parts are the root, stem, leaves and branches, correct? And they are not involved in reproduction. They are usually responsible for many different other functions, like roots absorb water from the soil, the stem supports the plant body, the leaves manufacture food, okay, and they are not involved in reproduction. But what are reproductive parts? Reproductive parts are flower. Flower is the reproductive part of a plant, and flower produces what? The flower produces fruits, and fruits contain seeds. Okay, so that's why we say that flowers are the reproductive parts of plants. So the structure of Brassica has been divided into two broad categories on the basis of function: vegetative parts and reproductive parts. Vegetative parts are those which do not directly take part in sexual reproduction, and the reproductive parts consist of sex organs which are directly related to sexual reproduction. Vegetative parts mein the first is root. The root is the part which grows under the soil and it develops from the radicle of the seed. जब हम roots की बात करते हैं तो roots are developed from the radicle of the seed and the first part of the root arises from radicle. You can see figure 2.27 at page number 46. Page 46 पे आपको एक root का structure नजर आ रहा है जो मेन रूट होती है जो बीच में से डेवलप होती है दैट इज कॉल्ड प्राइमरी रूट और प्राइमरी रूट में से बहुत सारी दूसरी रूट्स डेवलप होती हैं ओके सो द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट को हम स्टडी करेंगे आज जब हम रूट को इंटरनली देखते हैं तो रूट का इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर जो फिगर 2.27 में शोन है उसमें आपको कुछ इस तरीके का स्ट्रक्चर नजर आ रहा है जो बिल्कुल सेंटर ऑफ द रूट है वो ऐसा है और बाकी चीजें कुछ इस तरीके से हैं ठीक है मैं इसको फर्दर चेंज करूंगी ये वाला स्ट्रक्चर जो आपके बुक में शो किया गया है दिस इज द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट एंड यू कैन सी दैट द आउटर मोस्ट पार्ट द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर इज एपिडर्मिस डू यू सी एपिडर्मिस This epidermis is the outermost layer which is present externally. Okay? And what is the function of epidermis? This epidermis actually protects the internal cells. And you can see that the root hairs are arising from the epidermal cells. The epidermal cells are giving rise to root hair cells. These root hairs are responsible to absorb water. The root hairs are the extension of epidermal cells. After the epidermis, we have this part, which part is called cortex. This is the part which is called cortex. All these cells are cortex. And here in this region, the food is stored. Starch storage cells are found. Now these cells, this is the layer of the cell which is surrounding the pericycle, surrounding the xylem and phloem. This is called endodermis. Epidermis, which is the outermost layer, and endodermis is actually surrounding the xylem and phloem, which are the vascular tissues. So this structure is actually endodermis and these are actually surrounding the vascular tissues. Vascular tissues mein this part is xylem. I'm writing X for xylem. This is xylem. Xylem is the water conducting tissue. Xylem. Water conducting tissue. Why are we calling it tissue? Because it is made up of many cells. Okay? So xylem is water conducting tissue. Xylem is water conducting tissue. Okay, got it? Oh, all right. Yes, you people are going to make this diagram. ये diagram आपके paper में आती भी है draw करने के लिए भी और label करने के लिए भी ठीक है Okay, now I think I have answered the questions. See, xylem tissue is water conducting tissue. And water conducting tissue means कि xylem ने water को conduct करना है. Now another thing is we have to find out what is the function of phloem. Phloem is a food conducting tissue. And where can you see the phloem? You can see the phloem here. You can see the phloem here. This is phloem okay and phloem is a we know that xylem is a water conducting tissue and phloem is a food conducting tissue. It conducts food. जो food leaves में बनेगा उसको हम देखते हैं कि वो phloem में जमा हो जाता है और फिर वो food पूरी cell body में conduct कर दिया जाता है. ठीक है. सो वाटर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू, जाइलम को हम टिश्यू कह रहे हैं क्योंकि ये भी बहुत सारे सेल्स से मिलकर बना है, और फ्लोम को भी हम टिश्यू कह रहे हैं क्योंकि ये भी बहुत डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स से मिलकर बना है. सो जाइलम एंड फ्लोम आर मेकिंग अप द वैस्कुलर टिश्यूज. ये प्लांट बॉडी को सपोर्ट भी करते हैं और ये मटीरियल्स को कंडक्ट भी करते हैं. ये बिल्कुल सेंटर ऑफ द रूट में प्रेजेंट होते हैं. इसके अलावा यहाँ वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम मौजूद होता है और ये अदर सेल्स हैं जो कॉर्टेक्स और कैम्बियम वगैरह बनाते हैं. ये मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ प्रोवाइड करते हैं रूट को. ओके. सो दिस इज द बेसिक इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द रूट. यू कैन सी द रूट हेयर्स. रूट हेयर्स आर द एक्सटेंशंस ऑफ एपिडर्मिस. एपिडर्मिस के बाद कॉर्टेक्स है. कॉर्टिकल सेल्स जो होते हैं वो स्टार्च को स्टोर कर रहे होते हैं, और इसके अलावा ये मैकेनिकल स्ट्रेंथ भी देते हैं किसी हद तक. और एंडोडर्मिस, ये एंडोडर्मिस है जो कि वैस्कुलर टिश्यूज को सराउंड करेगी. एंडोडर्मिस के अंदर एक पेरिसाइकिल वाले सेल्स हैं, पेरिसाइकिल का एरिया होता है. उसके बाद ये जो स्टार शेप्ड स्ट्रक्चर है, दिस इज जाइलम, दिस इज वाटर कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू. और यहाँ पे जो आपको ये स्ट्रक्चर्स नजर आ रहे हैं, दीज आर फ्लोम. फ्लोम इज फूड कंडक्टिंग टिश्यू. वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम भी मौजूद होता है. ठीक है. सो ऑल दिस फिनिशेस विद द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट. एंड हियर इज द पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट. यहाँ पे आपको ये फर्दर इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ रूट शो किया गया है. ये स्टार शेप्ड जाइलम है और ये फ्लोम नजर आ रहा है. नाउ if we move back here, this is the internal structure of stem. Is this picture given in your book? This picture is the transverse section of stem, and this is figure 2.28. I have found exactly the same picture which is given in your book. क्योंकि अगर मैं इसके अलावा कोई picture show करती तो आपके लिए बहुत problem हो जाता, आप फिर उसका understand नहीं कर सकते थे. So here I am just going to explain you this internal structure of stem. And internal structure of stem mein hum sabse pehle observe kar rahe hain epidermis ko. Yes, internal structure of stem is also included in your syllabus, and ye epidermis ka part hai. You can see the epidermis. Outermost layer is epidermis. Epidermis ke baad dobara se कॉर्टिक्स आ गया. कॉर्टिक्स के बाद ये एंडोडर्मिस है, और एंडोडर्मिस के बाद यहाँ पे जो आपको जाइलम नजर आ रहा है वो ये वाला पार्ट है. दिस इज जाइलम एंड दिस इज कैम्बियम. फ्लोम, आपको ये जो डार्क रीजन है, दिस इज फ्लोम. दिस डार्क रीजन इज फ्लोम. हियर इट इज फ्लोम. ओके. कैम्बियम, जाइलम, एंड दिस सेंट्रल पार्ट इज द pit. Okay, so the internal structure of stem is very much similar to the internal structure of root, but in stem we see that there are no root hairs on the epidermis. There is a short cortex and endodermis bhi hai. Iske sath phloem tissue is tarike se hame dark nazar aa raha hai kyunki iske andar food maujood hai aur wo food yahan se conduct ho raha hai. कैम्बियम टिश्यू भी है, और कैम्बियम टिश्यू के साथ हमें यहाँ जाइलम टिश्यूज नजर आ रहे हैं जो कि वाटर को कंडक्ट करेंगे. एंड आफ्टर दैट द सेंट्रल मोस्ट पार्ट इज पिथ. ओके. हैव यू गॉट द थिंग्स? हैव यू गॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट? आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू द इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्टेम. एंड द स्टेम ऑफ ब्रासिका इज एक्चुअली थिन. It is green in color, and the stem contains nodes and internodes. Nodes or internodes wo parts hote hain. The point on the stem which gives rise to leaf. Jahan se leaf arise hoga wo hum usko hum node kahenge, aur jahan se jo do different nodes ke beech mein jo area hai, that is called internode. Theek hai. लीव्स के साथ साथ जो स्टेम होती है वो भी ग्रीन होती है ब्रासिका की, और ये भी फोटोसिंथेसिस परफॉर्म कर सकती है. ऑल दिस पार्ट कैन बी रेड आउट फ्रॉम द बुक. अब हम क्योंकि बहुत क्लास के एंड की तरफ जा रहे हैं, वी हैव लेफ्ट विद 10 मिनट्स ओनली, सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू टू आस्क मी इफ देर आर एनी क्वेश्चंस. आर देर एनी क्वेश्चंस? Any questions related to this part? Interview. Where is interview? Misha, what are you writing, beta? Internode. Okay. Internode is the area on a stem when which is between the two nodes. आपने देखा है स्टेम के ऊपर थोड़ा सा उभरा हुआ रीजन होता है, वो जो सोलन रीजन होता है स्टेम के ऊपर थोड़े थोड़े स्पेसेस के बाद, वहां से लीव्स अराइज होते हैं. और जो टू सोलन रीजन के बीच में जो एरिया होगा, जो गैप होगा, उसको हम इंटरनोड कहेंगे. एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? फंक्शन ऑफ पिथ. फंक्शन ऑफ पिथ जो होता है वो इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं होता कि वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स से बना होता है और इसमें फूड मटेरियल को स्टोर किया जाता है. द पिथ कंटेन्स पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स. पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स हमने कल पढ़ा था कि लिविंग सेल्स होते हैं, दे फंक्शन टू स्टोर द फूड, और पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स में बस फूड स्टोर किया जाता है, इसके अलावा पेट का कोई फंक्शन नहीं है. कैम्बियम. कैम्बियम में बहुत सारे मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स होते हैं, और आपको पता है मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स क्या करेंगे, वो स्टेम की विड्थ को बढ़ाएंगे, यानी स्टेम को जो सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ होती है, जो स्टेम ब्रॉडर होती जाती है, वो कैम्बियम की एक्टिविटी से होती है. और कैम्बियम की वजह से जो स्टेम है वो थिकनेस में इंक्रीज होती जाती है. द क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग टू मी. सुमैया इज आस्किंग, मिस वी वर फॉलोइंग द यस्टरडे सेल्फ स्टडी फॉर दिस चैप्टर. यस यस, यू हैव टू डू ऑल दोज क्वेश्चंस. आई गिव यू सम मोर सेल्फ स्टडी क्वेश्चंस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास इंशाल्लाह आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग दिस पार्ट ब्रासिका. अभी ब्रासिका में मैंने आपको लीफ, इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लीफ और फ्लावर को एक्सप्लेन करना है. सो ड्यूरिंग आवर नेक्स्ट क्लास इंशाल्लाह आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट द लीफ, इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लीफ, फ्लावर ऑफ ब्रासिका एंड इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फ्लावर. आफ्टर दैट आई विल गिव यू द सेल्फ स्टडी फॉर दीज टू क्लासेस, द टॉपिक्स वी हैव कवर्ड इन दीज टू क्लासेस. लेसन 8 और लेसन 9 का सेल्फ स्टडी इंशाल्लाह मैं आपको लेसन 9 के एंड पे दूंगी. Any other questions, any other confusions related to notes, related to working? Yes, you have to do that self-study. School open Wednesday to Wednesday ki hai. Nahin, abhi school open nahi honge. Abhi aapka online class hi chalegi. To online classes mein aapka chapter 2 hopefully complete ho jayega. Theek hai? और इसको आप कोशिश ही कीजिए कि जल्दी जल्दी से इसको आप मुझे सेल्फ स्टडी कंप्लीट करते जाइए, और मुझे आप इन्फॉर्म करते जाइए कि कौन से ऐसे क्वेश्चंस हैं जो डिफ़िकल्ट हैं, जिसमें आपको प्रॉब्लम हो रही है, वो मुझसे आप प्लीज़ साथ साथ पूछते जाइए. और अगर कोई ऐसे कॉन्सेप्ट्स हैं जो डिफ़िकल्ट हैं तो आप मुझे बता दीजिए. तो यह क्या चीज़ मैं दोबारा रिवाइज करवाऊँ, मेरे लिए तो बहुत मुश्किल है पूरा रिवाइज करवाना. कोई स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक है तो वो आप पूछ लिया कीजिए. Schools open होंगे, management will inform you up, okay? Yes, a broadcast group, you can contact me, I have shared my contact with you, all right? So it's time to say Allah Hafiz to all of you. I just want to say thank you once again, and please work upon your self-study. Today's self-study is to read all the pages from page number 44 to page number 47. Page 44 to 47. Read all these pages, and if you have any questions, you can ask me in the next class. Okay, students. Thank you so much. It's time to say Allah Hafiz to all of you. Allah Hafiz. Have a nice day to you too, Alishba. Thank you. Jazakallah.